Hi, everybody. It's Natalie Kling from The Art of Clean Living. Today is day 6 of my juice fast, and I have a huge confession to make. Last night was day 5, and I think I might have told you that it was a particularly stressful day for a lot of reasons. And then I was home alone with Killian, my son, around 4 o'clock, and my emotions were getting really intense. I was getting really, really irritated and just upset, and I didn't want to lose my cool with him. So I justified a cheat, and I had an avocado, a whole avocado with sea salt. And it was actually, it was so funny because I ate it, and then I felt really, I felt super calm after that. And then I felt really, really full. Like, one avocado made me feel, like, you know, unusually full, which is kind of interesting. My stomach has probably shrunk down. But as soon as I did it, I knew that I was just to take the edge off. It was just to, like, get through the moment with my kid, and then I was going to be back on it. So here I am, day 6. And I have to say, last night I had to babysit him and another kid, and we had a pizza party. I made pizza and sweet potato fries, which were like my favorite, and a bunch of food and snacks and dessert, banana bread and coconut bliss ice cream, and I almost totally blew it. I was like, I should just, you know, I'll be so comforted if I eat this food. I'll be so happy. I'm going to have a glass of wine. It's been a long day. Maybe 5 days is fine. I've got to comfort myself. And I didn't do it. And in the moment I was thinking, the only thing that held me back was I was thinking, ultimately, this is a choice. There doesn't have to be a bunch of stuff attached to either choice. It's just a choice. I can say eat or not eat, continue the fast or not continue the fast. And I chose to continue the fast. And I thought to myself, I'm like, okay, if I continue the fast, I'm going to be really proud of myself. If I don't, I'm going to feel a lot better right now. And then I'm going to wake up tomorrow and be like, shit, I should have kept going. So anyways, I chose not to break my fast completely or blow it. I just continued to stay on it. So I had broth, and I made myself a big carrot juice. And I somehow got through the night. It was really, really hard. I was texting my friends being like, this is the worst. I'm dying, you know, and people were texting me back like, you can do it. So I was like, God, I have to do it. So anyways, I'm back on day 6. I started today with, I had a headache in the morning. I did my bouncing routine on the trampoline, which is super, super effective for detox, because every time you bounce, you're squeezing your cells and you have about 3 G's of force that's applied on your body. So it's a great exercise for detox. And then I did an hour in the sauna, which was amazing. I meditated, and I'm back on track. So day 6, we'll see how it goes.